supposed to die tonight.
Niggas done put a hit out and they talking like this shit okay.
What's good, y'all? Still one and only NY Fina, the most phenomenal voice in sports. Make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, go and subscribe to the Phenomenal Crew. Now, let's get to it. Listen, before I speak about the Ravens, make sure you guys follow me on Twitter and Instagram, alright? Make sure you guys follow me on all that good shit, alright? Like I always say, if you ain't following me on Twitter and Instagram, if you ain't following me on both platforms, you're missing out. That's all I can really tell y'all. That's all I can really tell y'all. If you ain't following me on both platforms, you're missing out. Alright? But on to the topic at hand, y'all. Hear me out. The Ravens made some good moves earlier today, alright? So, since John Harbaugh and, I keep on forgetting who the GM is over there in Baltimore. I think, Eric DaCosta? Is it that? Because it's not Ozzie Newman anymore. Ozzie Newman is not there anymore. I think it's Eric DaCosta, something like that. So, you know, they've been making moves today. All right, so the first move that they made earlier this morning was traded for Yannick Ngakoue. They made a move for Yannick Ngakoue. All right, the Ravens, they traded their third-round pick in a 2022 fifth-round pick for Yannick Ngakoue. I honestly can't get mad at this move at all. I mean, honestly, if I put my Ravens hate bias aside, because I can't stand you dirty-ass, nasty-ass Ravens fans, and you Ravens fans know what I'm talking about. You dirty-ass pieces of shit. But at the end of the day, hear me out. Trading for another pass rusher is a great move. I can't even get mad at it, y'all. I can't get mad at it. Listen, one thing that's always lacked from this team, especially last year, was a pass rush. That was one thing that was lacking last year because you had the corners. Marlon Humphrey is a stud. It's the reason why you guys resigned him. Marlon Humphrey is a top five corner. Marcus Peters is one of the best zone corners in the NFL. You got Jimmy Smith. You got Chuck Clark. You don't have my man Earl Thomas anymore. Earl Thomas, you guys didn't get the good ET3. The whole entire Earl Thomas situation in Baltimore was an entire mess. Earl Thomas didn't have the same success he had in Seattle and Baltimore. So at the end of the day, you guys don't have Earl Thomas anymore, but I mean, you got the secondary, right? Calais Campbell up the middle, Derek Wolf. I'm gonna keep it a buck, Ravens fans. I don't care how y'all feel. Are we sure Patrick Queen is really that good? He won Defensive Player of the Week. Okay. I still got my concerns because from all the scouts, from all the film I watch, he still can't stop the run. So it is what it is. But one thing that was lacking on this team was two consistent pass rushers because you had Matthew Judon. But my thing about Judon is he's not a true number one pass rusher. Now, Yannick Ngakoue is not a true number one pass rusher either. But if you get two really good, solid pass rushers off the edge, then it boosts your pass rush. It just does. It makes your defensive line better. The pass rush is better. You get two solid players. I mean, look at Green Bay. Look at the Smith brothers. It's Darius and Preston Smith. They're monsters. You got two players off the edge. It creates havoc. It does. Yannick Ngakoue, he had five sacks in Minnesota. The whole entire Vikings situation is a mess. I told you guys Yannick Ngakoue wasn't going to prosper with the Vikings because the Vikings defense wasn't good enough overall, especially with Daniel Hunter injured. So at the end of the day, I told you guys that was a bad move from the beginning. Listen, it just is what it is. The Vikings are a mess. But as far as the Ravens, if you think that you guys can win right now, you make this move. You make the move. You trade for Yannick Ngakoue. So I don't have any issues with the Yannick Ngakoue trade. Boosts the pass rush. The defense is going to still be a top five unit. Cool. Dez Bryant. Yo, shout out to Dez B. Shout out to Dez Bryant. I've always been a big Dez Bryant fan. I always have. Dez has been my dude. Listen, hear me out. It's good to see that Dez is going to be back in the NFL. Salute. Mr. X himself, one of my favorite receivers of the decade. I don't got a negative thing to say about Dez in his prime. But guess what, y'all? Y'all not getting 2014 Dez. You're not getting 2012, 2011 Dez, the Dez that was catching tubs from Tony Romo. Let's keep it a buck, y'all. Dez Bryant is over the hill. He's over the hill, y'all. He just is. So, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm happy to see Dez Bryant back in the NFL. I am. But at the end of the day, y'all, don't expect Dez to be the number one receiver y'all been looking for. Don't expect it. Y'all should be all in on Antonio Brown. Y'all gave up Antonio Brown. It looks like my Seahawks are finna get Antonio Brown. You guys missed out. If there was one team that needed a number one receiver, it was y'all. I'm sorry. Dez is not going to fix y'all number one issues. Now, do I like Dez? Sure he is. But he's not going to be that same Dez that's going to catch 13 touchdowns and give you 1,500 yards. He was never the best route runner. As much as I love Dez, Dez was never the best route runner. Never created that much separation. But at the end of the day, Dez is a freak of nature. Now, are we sure Dez is going to be that athletic after coming off a full-on Achilles injury? Hell no. He's 31 years old. He's coming off Achilles injury. He's not going to be as athletic as he is. I really don't see Dez making that big of an impact, y'all. Truth be told, y'all already have a Dez Bryant on your team. Isn't Miles Boykin the Dez Bryant prototype? A player that can catch contested balls and get down the field and block? Because that's all Dez Bryant really is going to do. One thing that Dez will help in is Dez Bryant, he'll be a good blocker. Dez Bryant's always been one of the best blocking receivers. Dez Bryant blocks like a tight end. Dez Bryant blocks like a tight end. So he's going to help in that department with all the read options and all that bullshit QB blast that you guys like to run with Lamar Jackson. But I'm sorry, y'all. Dez Bryant doesn't help any issues when it comes to getting a receiver that can move the chains consistently. Because Willie Snead, Hollywood Brown, Miles Boykin, they not moving the chains consistently. Mark Andrews, he's nice, but like, come on now. If Mark Andrews is your number one receiver in your team as a tight end, there's an issue. And so, you know, overall, it's good to see that Dez is back in the NFL. It's a shame that Dez returning back to the NFL. He has to join a dirty piece of shit fan base like the Baltimore Ravens. So, you know, overall, I'll be cheering on Dez from afar. I'll be cheering on Dez from afar. I will. But at the end of the day, y'all, this still doesn't change anything, y'all. I mean, I'm still not picking y'all over the Steelers. I still can't pick y'all over the Titans because guess what? Getting another pass rusher helps you guys maybe versus the Chiefs. Maybe helps you guys versus the Chiefs so you guys don't have to blitz so much. Maybe so. Maybe that type of move, you know, makes you guys have a better chance of competing with the Chiefs, you know, because every single time Lamar Jackson meets up with Patrick Mahomes, he gets shit on. So at the end of the day, getting you guys another pass rusher, maybe that helps you versus the Chiefs. But a team like the Titans, Yannick Ngakoue is still not going to stop the run. So, I mean, at the end of the day, y'all, I'm not picking y'all over the Steelers. I'm not picking y'all over the Titans. I'm still not picking y'all over the Patriots. Y'all still, at best, the fifth best team in the AFC. So, at the end of the day, y'all, it is what it is. I'm not going to even bash the moves because, like I said, Yannick Ngakoue making that move, I actually think that was a smart trade. Bringing Dez Bryant, it doesn't fix y'all receiver options. It really doesn't. You just added a guy who can block and catch contested balls. I just don't see that really helping your team. I just really don't. And this is, like I said, this is coming from a big Dez Bryant fan. I just don't see that really helping your team. So at the end of the day, y'all, it is what it is. But you know, overall, man, Lamar Jackson's looked bad this year. He's looked bad. Mark Ingram wasn't Mark Ingram put on IR? So at the end of the day, y'all, I'm not believing this Ravens team. They don't got the same juice as they did last year. I'm just not feeling it. But that's all. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. I'm the Phenomenal One, and I'm out. Deuces. Shout out my Crips, they're still crippin', nigga. A-L-C.
Shout out my bloods that still blooding, niggas. Straight from the dirt, shout out my muddy niggas. Came from the bottom, all my get money niggas.
When I die, you ain't got to cry, you just got to pray. Put some weed where I lay, I'ma see another day. Full of energy, you my enemy, you got to pay. Was on the east side, fucking with them Crips the other day. Was on the west side.